Chairman, if you refer to the Education Bureau, they also engage a large number of NCSC staff. Last year, there were 1,190 people, and this year, 1,178 people. The difference is only 12 staff. Are you happy with this progress? Because the administration keeps talking about making improvements. Because the NCSC arrangement is not ideal. If you compare the figures for the 2 years, there are some differences. Last year, reasons for employment were basically because of school-based management scheme and special operational needs of public schools. 909 people were engaged, and this year that has been scrapped. And for the 900-odd people, they have been categorized into two types. One is to cater for time-limited seasonal service needs, 600-odd people, and then the second batch, mode of service delivery under review or likely to be changed, 500-odd. So for these two types of people, they are mainly working in public schools. So I don't quite understand. This breakdown allows us to understand better that there are some positions that are time limited and seasonal, and then some, the nature of service, are being reviewed or to be changed. But what does that really mean? Inside public schools, what type of work is seasonal? What type of work is being under reviewed or likely to be changed in relation to the mode of service delivery? Can you explain more? For the Education Bureau, they have 1,178 full-time NCSC staff. 380-odd are working in public schools. And basically, they are serving time-limited or short-term positions. For example, they are providing services in relation to funds and grants. So all these are quite short-term positions. We also have the language support scheme, and also under the free kindergarten education scheme, there are positions that are time-limited as well. 200-odd of such staff are engaged at the headquarters of the EDB. Some, the service delivery mode are being reviewed or will be changed soon. 500-odd are working under the funding flexibility scheme in government schools. And then a smaller number of them are working under different schemes in relation to new arrival students and non-Chinese speaking students. The Education Bureau will need to engage people from the open market to carry out work that is not being carried out by existing civil servants. For example, under the Basic Competency Assessment Project, about 0.5% of such staff, they work less than the conditioned hours. For example, assistant operational officers, they visit schools from time to time to inspect the work of non-registered schools. But their working hours are very different from the civil servants. These are basically the positions where the NCSC staff are engaged. Well, Secretary, you talked about funding flexibility scheme in government schools where NCSC staff are engaged. I want to ask about the scheme. Why do you call it funding flexibility scheme? And the people engaged are engaged on contract terms. The purpose is to allow flexible use of resources in government schools. So at different times, the schools may need different talents. For example, for a certain subject, they need some staff, or at a different time, they need help for a different subject.